In this After Effects tutorial, we combine motion graphics and video. It's about adding a second layer of information which interacts with your video. It's about playing with that contrast between nice footage and bold graphics. It's about adding a story or a second narrative level. Hi everyone, my name is Manuel. Let's animate some mograph on video, shall we? I got the footage I used from motionarray.com. Link is in the description. You can download the clips as previews. First of all, let's take a look at the skateboard scene. Here it is. I chose a 3-second part. Now we need to track the motion of the skateboard. That's what our graphics are attached to. If you can't see it here, go to Window and choose Tracker. We want to track the motion, which creates a track point. Then we add a null object, which is our target. Then I usually expand the search region and the feature region around the attach point, which slows it down but I think makes it more exact. We place the target point on a high contrast pixel which is visible the whole time and see if it works. Analyze. If it doesn't work, you simply reset and try a different point. We just want to track the position in this case. You could add rotation and scale as well. If it looks good, we click Apply. Both dimensions and the null object is attached to the board. Awesome. Next, we grab the pen tool and draw a shape to the left of the right wheel, like a dust cloud. We fine-tune the shape a little bit, then we add wave warp. And very important, we link it to the null. Let's name it Dust, or something like that. Okay, so wave height, around 10, is probably okay. Wave width, around 60 maybe. We change the direction. Let's reduce the wave height slightly. And we need to make it way faster. The wave speed, around 5 should be right. Next, we simply duplicate the shape. Move it left and adjust the form. That's basically it. Then you simply add a few little graphic accents, like animated strokes or little objects that fly off. All linked to the null, of course. Awesome. If you want to add an interacting graphic layer, the challenge is not the animations, it's the planning before shooting your footage. You should have a complete storyboard to make sure there's enough space for your graphics. You have to make sure the background is easy to key, and you might have to add tracking markers. And you should think about the timing. There should be enough time to read texts and for the graphics to actually animate. You need to get your content and the storyboard approved, because once your video footage is shot or bought, it will be hard to change stuff. What if you would be able to download as much footage as you want, plus music, sound effects, templates, and plugins for After Effects and Premiere Pro? Don't tell your clients though, because it saves you a lot of time and money. It's one subscription for all. Pay once, use it as much as you want. Subscribe through the link in the description and get $50 off. motionarray.com. Start now. But before, let's have a quick look at these glowing headphones. I already tracked the motion of the headphones. The target was a null object again. Then, with no layer selected, we grab the pen tool. I usually hide fill and stroke to see the whole picture. And let's zoom in here. We draw a shape around the earpiece. Kind of rough. Then we fine-tune the shape. Let's name it Mask. Fill white. And we need to link it to the null, of course. Then we add a new solid. Choose the color we want it to be. Name it Shine. Or whatever. And we use the mask as Luma inverted mask for the solid. Link it to the null as well. Then we use the ellipse tool to add a mask to the solid, around the earpiece. We open the mask property and add a mask feather. To get a glowing edge, we duplicate the mask solid. Rename it Glow. We hide the fill. Add a cyan stroke instead, width around 5 pixels. Not bad, but of course we need to add a glow. Glow radius around 20. Even better, we add it twice. increase the glow radius to around 100 and the intensity to 2. And now you could add all kinds of additional graphics. Finally, let's take a quick look at the snapping fingers from the beginning. A green screen would be best to key out the background, but let's try this one. Let's go to keying and add key light, first of all. Then let's pick this gray as screen color. That doesn't look too bad. Let's adjust the screen gain a little bit. There's this black outline still. In screen matte, let's play with the clip black setting a little bit. Adjust the screen gain. It's basically trial and error. Then let's slightly shrink the screen. And the black outline is almost gone. Then I usually add the background solid. In this case, we add a color gradient to see how exact I have to key anyway. The background will be quite dark, so the rough edges won't be obvious. Just make sure the lighting is consistent. So brighter towards the left and darker on the right side. And of course, we adjust the position. To link it to the background, we add a drop shadow. First of all, let's add curves to adjust the contrast. Just a tiny bit. Then let's add a drop shadow. We add some softness and distance. We adjust the shadow direction. The distance indicates the distance to our background. Of course, we duplicate the drop shadow and add much more softness to the second one. Let's move the arm further away from the background and add a text layer. Check out the links in the description. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and hit the bell, because you don't want to miss my next video. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, guys!